With the Dark Railway's summer gala done and dusted, things soon settled back into some sort of normality around the line. Whilst Gary had sadly been returned to his home in Wales, Stan had remained on the railway, apparently to help out so that Dave, Clyde and the others could get some decent maintenance. Unbeknownst to most of the engines, however, this wasn't the only reason that Stan was remaining on the Dark Railway. I understand that, Stan, but surely there's another way.
There is, of course there is. I could be sent home by ship, but Lord Stavell doesn't like the idea. Too risky with the other stuff going on with British Rail. He'd rather I didn't come home until this trouble blows over, or at least until there's a rail connection back to the island.
Well, you know you're welcome to stay here, right?
Oh, of course. Zeke has been really good. He understands the situation. Says that as long as I don't mind putting in some turns so you guys can have a rest, I'm free to stay as long as I need to. Gary did offer me to go with him, but I think I'd be more comfortable here with you, mate. Besides, if I were close to home, I'd just think about it more.
I'm sure that we can find a distraction for you here, mate.
I hope so. I really do. I know that you don't want me to harp on about it, but it worries me, you know.
I know. I'd worry about the Dark Railway if I was away for any length of time. This has been my home for almost 20 years now, and you get attached to these places, and the people and engines you meet and befriend along the way.
Exactly that. Of course, family is important as well, that's why I like these visits so much, getting to see you. Though, I think you're long overdue to come and visit New Wessex and the Stovall Valley line again. What do you think? When everything's sorted out, want to come for a while? If Zeke can spare you, of course.
You know what? I reckon that's not a bad idea, Stan. I could use a proper holiday. Have to see if Hannah doesn't mind me going, of course.
I'm sure she won't mind. I'll convince her to let you come regardless. Oh, it'll be wonderful. There's so much of the island that you haven't seen before. And Dave, honestly, the viaducts and the bridges and the tunnels.
Dave grimaced at this.
What's wrong?
Tunnels.
Tunnels? What about them?
Well, ever since, you know, the tunnel collapsed at Mirkum Gasworks, I've been terrified of the things.
That was a fluke accident. There's nothing wrong with tunnels, mate. Honestly, I go through them all the time. And what about that tunnel down the line? Haven't you been up to Belgrave yet?
No. I seized up my brake blocks and ruined my tyres when I tried to go through it last. I'm sorry, mate. I know it sounds stupid, but...
It's a subconscious thing, isn't it?
Sadly, yes.
But that's going to make coming to New Wessex a problem. It's full of tunnels, and there's even a great big tunnel just to get to the island.
Yikes. Stan pondered for a few moments before speaking up again.
Well, I've got an idea, if you're willing to try it.
Go on.
Why don't we try and tackle your fear of tunnels whilst I'm here? It'll take my mind off things. I know, I mean, you shouldn't have a problem coming back to my railway for a visit. Of course, if you want to.
Of course I want to!
Then we'll start planning what we can do. Obviously, I'm not just going to drag you up to the tunnel and force you in there. That'll make things much worse. We'll work out a plan, mate.
Thanks, Stan.
You're very welcome, brother. Now then, let's get some sleep, eh? I'm cream crackered.
So am I. Good night, Stan.
Good night, Dave.
One bright morning, Barry was heading over to the station to take his first train of the day. But something distracted him as he arrived. Stood nearby was an engine he hadn't seen for a long while.
Hey up, it's little old Lino. How the biscuits ins are ya?
Lino looked at Barry with surprise. Oh, Barry, it's you!
Of course it's me. Who else would it be?
Barry, I've got to tell you and the others about something. It's really important!
You haven't been chatting up younger engines on your travels, have you? Come on, lad. Even Barry knows that's frowned upon in these parts.
Barry! I'm being serious! It's about Repulse! Barry looked taken aback.
Repulse?
Yeah, Repulse! You know her, right?
Of course I do. She was restored alongside me in Mr. Crash's old works.
Well, that idiot girl is up to something, and I don't know what!
What are you waffling on about?
I saw her, whilst I was up at the Keighley and Worth Valley. She was on the main line. But she wasn't wearing her nameplates, and she didn't have her usual number. She's masquerading as that nasty piece of work Leanne. But why? Leanne's dead. We saw to that all those years ago. So why is she pretending to be her? I need to ask everyone else about this.
No, Lino. You're not to tell anybody about what you saw.
And, beg pardon?
Honora Pulse is currently running around dressed up as that demon lass, and I don't know why. But please, Lino, don't tell the others about this.
Why not? After everything that's happened, shouldn't they be warned? I don't understand what Repulse is up to, but...
But it's none of our business, Lino. Please. I met her whilst I was out on the main line with Garrucus. She made us promise not to tell anyone around here about her.
Well, you might have, but I haven't made any such promises to anyone.
Now listen here, Pretender Lino. I have asked very nicely and politely for you to keep your small box shut. Now, Barry is a kindly and caring engine, and doesn't often resort to violence. And I don't want to either. Too messy and it takes way too much time to clean everything up. So please, Lino. She wants to keep it a secret, and after the way you lot drove her away from here, I think you owe her that much to keep quiet about this. Understood?
Lino noted how sincere Barry looked, and looked off into the distance. Alright, Barry. I won't say anything about it. Okay?
Thank you, Lino. I appreciate this, and so does the universe. And above all else, the Creator thanks you for not pandering to people with a fascination for things a bit too further south for anyone's liking.
Right.
Well, those screeching banshees are looking mighty miffed that I haven't taken them on their trip yet, so I'd better take my leave. I'll shout over to the sheds for someone to come and get you, Lima. But remember what I said.
Alright, Barry. I can't tell if he's being serious or not half the time. But maybe it's for the best that I don't bring it up on reflection. Eventually, Ryan trundled over to the yard to pick Lino up. Hello, Lino. All right, Ryan. Yeah, mate. I'm pretty swell, actually. How was your trip up north? Pretty uneventful, I suppose. Glad to be home again, then? Oh, yes. It was pleasant enough. The line was quite pretty, and there are some nice engines there. But it isn't like being at home among your true friends, is it?
I suppose not, no. Well, come on then, mate. I suppose you'd like to get back to the sheds and rest.
Rest? Of course not, Ryan. I want to get back to work as soon as I can. I want to feel the familiar rails beneath my axles again. See my dear old friends and see what's new. It's been a long time.
Haha, suit yourself, mate. But I'll take you to the sheds anyway.
Thank you.
Lino was glad to be back among his friends again. He spent the rest of that day being prepared for work in the sheds, whilst catching up with everyone. However, as the sun began to set, an unfamiliar tank engine rolled into the shed road next to him.
Alright.
Hello?
Oh yes, well hello there. New engine, is it? Or old? I can't tell. Anyway, who are you?
I'm Lino. I'm a long-time resident of the line. You must have arrived whilst I was away.
Yeah, boy. I'm Goose.
Goose?
Yeah, as in...
Funny name.
Yeah, I guess it is. Still, could be worse. Could be my brother Virgil.
Virgil's not that weird a name. I quite like that, actually.
Eh, I prefer Goose to Virgil. Anyway, that's enough rubbish about names. It's the engines that carry them that are of interest. So, Lino, tell me more about yourself.
Well, I was built in 1890 at Horwich Works, and I worked on my own branch line back in Lancashire for most of my early life, before becoming a station pilot at Preston for several years. Then, British Railways happened.
Oh yes, British Railways, I remember.
After several years being shunted around various depots, me and my crew decided to escape to the south once withdrawals began. We came here, where Colin and Eddie saved me.
Wait, Eddie saved you?
Yes. He and Colin saw me hiding at the old carriage sidings at Kolhapa and brought me to Mr. Dark, who purchased me from British Railways after some help from Theo and Otto.
Wow, that's really good of them to do that for you.
It was. Everyone else had given up on me, but not the engines here. I am so proud to call them my friends. Sad that Colin is no longer with us, of course. Nor Owen. Nor Kammer.
Lino lapsed into silence for a moment, thinking about his old friends that were long departed. Looking up, he noticed that Goose was still looking inquisitively at him. He pulled himself together.
How about you, Goose? What's your story?
I was built at the grand old Swindon Works, where literally everyone from the GWR seems to have been built. I used to work on various branches all over the Western system, but eventually I wound up with my very own branch line in Cornwall, running from a big mainline station to a town called Brentwell. Lovely place. And a great relationship with the townsfolk from the villages along the line. I love them, they love me. I ran the line single-handedly for many years, with just a few engines coming along to help from time to time. Eddie was, funnily enough, one of them.
So you'd met Eddie previously?
Yeah, and his shitty friend, Maxon. What twat he was. Anyway, by 1966, British Rail decided they wanted to close the line and get rid of me. The villagers and myself argued against the closure, of course, but as usual, British Rail knows best, and they shut us the fuck down. They tried to take me away for scrap. The mayor of Brentwell wasn't having any of it, thankfully. He bought me there and then, and had me displayed in the town as a monument for many years. But though I'd been saved, I was unhappy, because I wanted to work. The branch line that I once called my home had long since been demolished, so the mayor found someone to buy me and run me again. And that man was Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chairman? Oh, so you're a society engine?
Yeah, sadly.
Oh, aren't you a fan?
Not really. I like Mr. Chairman because he's the only society member that actually talks to us. The rest of them just... exist. Or at least they used to. Dunno really, a lot of them just don't seem to be around anymore.
Oh dear, that's not good.
Not really, no. But oh well, never mind. At least I've got the Soma branch to keep me occupied.
Ah, so you run the Soma branch now?
Yes. Oh no, don't tell me that...
Used to be my job, yes.
Oh mate, no. Oh shit, I'm so sorry. I don't mind feeling like I've taken other engines' jobs.
I'm not going to lie. I'm a little bit upset at losing the Soma branch. But there's nothing that can be done about it. If Zeke and Chairman have an agreement for you to run the branch, Goose, then that's their decision, not mine. And I'm not going to be petty or moody about it. Besides, I'm not so young as I used to be. Perhaps it was time to pass the mantle on to another, younger engine anyway.
Goose hated the look on Lino's smokebox. It wasn't anger, nor indifference. It was acceptance, and Goose felt terribly guilty about it. He thought quickly, and a simple solution bubbled into his funnel.
Tell you what, dude. I'll speak to Mr. Chairman and Zeke, see if we can come to an arrangement for both of us to run the branch. Heck, I don't even mind doing goods work or permanent way duty anyway, so perhaps he could take over the operations on the Soma branch when I'm elsewhere. What'd you say?
Lino looked up at Goose. That's really thoughtful of you, Goose. Thank you. We will see what they think about our little arrangement tomorrow, I think.
Well, actually, I thought we could start right now.
What do you mean?
You're almost at pressure, right?
I think so, yeah.
I'm supposed to be working the evening shuttles tonight. Why don't you go and do them instead? Then you can see Theo and Otto again. I know they've mentioned you by name before, so I'm sure they'd be glad to see you again.
Oh, that would be wonderful. And you're sure you don't mind?
Absolutely. You can even take my coaches if you want to.
That would be nice. Thank you, Goose.
No problem, dude. Have fun.
I will.
Lino happily puffed away, whilst Goose smiled to himself, glad that he was continuing to make friends on this railway after such a turbulent start. Upon arriving at Soma, Lino found that he had plenty of time to spare before his booked return to Axley and headed over to the sheds to see the twins, who beamed as their old friend approached them.
Lino, you're home! Oh, we are pleased to see that you've come back safe and sound.
It's great to be home too. How have things been around here whilst I've been gone?
A lot has changed up here, as you can probably see.
Yeah. This place looks a little different, and the passengers seem to be able to explore the quarry site. How come?
The quarry shut down commercial operations a little while ago, when the viaduct collapsed.
Wait a moment! The viaduct collapsed!
That's what I said. Mr. B had a little accident whilst crossing it a few winters ago.
But it's... what? The viaduct, sir! It's right there! And it looks good as new!
Yes, indeed it is.
But how did it... oh, hold on. Let me guess. You used the tau cannon. I thought that it had problems with the thermic cycles.
It did. But we tried to fix it, for Clyde's sake.
Clyde? The diesel that used to visit us? What does he have to do with this?
Long story short, Clyde needed to disguise himself to hide from British Rail so he could stay here. So we used the tau cannon to repair the viaduct and help him. Unfortunately, the cannon malfunctioned and, well, disappeared.
Disappeared? Where did it go?
Who knows? Anyway, Clyde ended up being able to shapeshift. But after Dave got abducted by a demon...
a demon?
We were summoned by Pogo, and Clyde went off to save Dave, and came back as a Caledonian engine, permanently. A fascinating tale. You had to be there, really.
Right.
Anyway, that's enough exposition from us. How are you, Lino? How was your time away?
Oh, fine, I suppose. Nowhere near as exciting as what's been going on here, clearly. Just pulled a few trains, made a few new friends, lost my coaches.
Lost your coaches?
Yeah. Zeke sold them to the carriage trust based on that line. Said that he'd make it up to me when I got home.
I'm sure that he will. Besides, Goose does most of the shuttles up here at the moment.
Yes, I know. I met him back at Mirkum.
What do you think of him?
I think he's all right, really. Bit rough around the edges, but he seems to have a good heart. We're trying to come up with an agreement that will allow both of us to operate the passenger trains up here, so you'll still see me from time to time.
That would be splendid. Who knows? Maybe you'll be able to do some of the demonstration shunting with us sometimes, for the benefit of the visitors. Or even some of the demonstration goods trains. The trucks will be pleased to see you back.
I'll certainly ask. Oh, look at the time. I'd better get going. I will see you both soon, all right?
No problem, Lino. Honestly, we are thrilled to have you back with us again, old friend. See you soon.
See you both later.
And with that,
Lino headed back to the station, pleased that his friends were happy to have him home again, and that he had not been forgotten. The following morning, both Goose and Lino woke up early, with the intention of seeking out their respective owners to discuss their ideas regarding the Soma branch. After travelling back down the line, the two tank engines spotted the two men near the museum building at the junction, clearly in the middle of a conversation. "Quite understand the situation, Mr. Chairman, and I'm willing to let the rent situation slide for the time being. But if you and the Society do need help..."
"Look, I appreciate your concern, Zeke, I really do, but this is something that the Society has to manage as a whole. I may be the chairman, but we are a democracy and I have to run any official decisions by the other members. Besides, I don't want to put you nor your father under any more unnecessary burden right now, and..." "Hold on. Oh, Hull!"
Mr. Chairman hailed a welcome to both Goose and Lino as they pulled up in front of them. "Hello, Lino. Morning, Goose."
"Good morning, sirs."
"Aye."
"We're not too bad, thank you."
"How can we be of help?"
Goose and Lino glanced sideways at each other. Goose spoke first, addressing Mr. Chairman.
"Sirs, myself and Lino would like to ask if we could, perhaps, share the passenger duties on the Soma branch? I love doing them, you know I do, but as you know, I'd like to have a variety of jobs to get on with. And Lino would really appreciate running on the branch line again. I already said that I don't mind, but we appreciate that it's your decision to make, so we thought we'd ask."
"I think that would be good for both of us, sirs. If Goose has somewhere else to be, I can cover for him, and vice versa. If you are both in agreement, of course."
The two men looked at each other for a moment before they spoke.
"Well, I don't see that being a problem. And I can't imagine the Society rejecting such a proposal, especially if Zeke were to arrange it officially. They can't argue with that, but as a matter of courtesy, I will speak to the other members about it. It would free you up to do some much-needed permanent way tasks, Goose."
"And better yet, I think we could arrange for both of you to not only operate the trains to Soma, but on occasion, the line up to Belgrave too." "Yes indeed. I think this could work out quite nicely, if everybody is on board." The two tank engines beamed.
"A most excellent arrangement, Zeke. Very good."
"Actually, I'm glad that you came down here, Lino. I've got something to show you."
"Sir?"
"Come with me. Over here. Mr. Chairman, we'll finish this discussion later."
"Not a problem, Zeke. I'll speak to you soon."
Zeke went around to the other side of the museum building as Lino reversed back to the points, wondering what Zeke wanted to show him. It didn't take long for him to find out, as he saw Zeke switching various points to path Lino over to the carriage and wagon works, where the young manager stood, waiting. At this moment, Lino already had an idea what this was about. "So, Lino, I can see from the look on your smoke box that you've already worked out why I asked you over here."
"It's to do with my old carriages, isn't it, sir?"
"Correct, yeah. Look, Lino, I'm sorry that I sold them. The Worth Valley people took a keen interest in them and asked if I would be willing to part with them. I know I should have asked you first, but..."
"Oh, don't worry about it, sir. It's your property, your rolling stock."
"Of course, but I do like to take my engine's thoughts and feelings into consideration too, and for that, I apologise. That's why I brought you over here, to try and make amends. Not that I wasn't planning this anyway, but you know what I mean." Lino watched as Zeke opened one of the doors into the building and saw...
"Sir? Are those?"
"Yes, they are. These are your new coaches, Lino. Go on, you can bring them out here to have a look at them." Lino obliged, slowly rolling into the workshop and coupling up to the coaches. He brought them back outside and marvelled at them. "These, Lino, are for you, as a replacement for the ones that I sold. They're a bit more modern than the six-wheelers that you are used to, but..." But Lino interrupted.
"Oh, sir, I love them!" They look absolutely splendid. And proper bogey coaches too. And, sir, that's...
Lena was looking at the last of the three coaches.
She's an observation saloon. Oh, Zeke, they are beautiful. Thank you.
I hope that you would be pleased with them. Ex-LMS Period 3 Stania coaches. I do have more under restoration, but I wanted to specifically allocate these three to you. In fact, Lino, the observation coach is for a special duty I have in mind for you. If you're in agreement, I'd like you to help me with inspections of the line, using that coach to help us carry out those duties.
Oh, I'd like that.
So it's all worked out well in the end. I'm glad you like them, Lino. Please take them as an apology for me selling your old ones.
I shall. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
That's quite all right. Now off you go, Lino. I'd like you to take some local trains up and down the line with your new coaches today, so that they can be running a little and you can stretch your wheels.
I will. Thank you, Zeke.
Lino happily steamed away as Zeke went off in search of Mr. Chairman again. Soon, the operations on the Soma branch were rearranged. Whenever Goose was away doing other jobs for the Society, Lino would bring his own coaches up onto the branch between his other tasks. Both Lino and Goose were, of course, rather pleased with this, but elsewhere, another tank engine was about to receive some rather less pleasant news.
Withdrawn? But sir! I thought you'd got me an extension on my current boiler ticket.
I did, and unfortunately, Brian, that extension has now come to an end.
And why is he here?
I have a name, you know. Abomination is here because he's also come to the end of his own boiler ticket, and is also being withdrawn.
Does that mean...
Yes, Brian. It means that I'm putting you both in the museum for a while.
Oh man, not the museum, sir. Can't you just, you know, push me up the overhaul queue?
Honestly, Brian, I would if I could, but the museum needs locomotives to exhibit. At the moment, we only have Hannah and Della Tripp in there, so we need more engines out on display.
But...
And besides, I can't put you in for an overhaul at the moment anyway.
Why not?
Because Mr. Smash is closing down his works for a while. There are some major renovations required to the building and foundations, so he needs the works completely empty so that this necessary work can be done. He just has one or two small jobs to complete, and then his works will be shut for the foreseeable future.
Brian frowned, but Abomination smiled.
Well, I for one won't mind helping you out, sir. I'll gladly go on display in the museum for you.
Only because you're a lazy little cock.
I'm not lazy. I've done lots of hard work lately.
With your mouth. I saw you gossiping with Alan over in the goods shed yesterday when you were supposed to be helping Stan with a demonstration goods train, so don't bullshit me on that.
I was... Alright, that's enough, you two. The two engines became instantly silent.
Look, I know it isn't the most glamorous of jobs, guys, but I'd rather have you two safely undercover for the public to view rather than being stuck in the back of the sheds collecting dust and grime.
Besides, you'll have Hannah and Tripp to speak to, Brian, so it's not all bad, is it?
Brian grunted unhappily. Abomination, on the other hand, was being sickeningly chipper about the entire ordeal.
That all sounds good to me, sir. When are we going on display? And are we going to get a good clean beforehand?
Ugh.
The plan is to continue operating the pair of you for the rest of this week, and then, we will have you both cleaned up and prepared for display in the museum in a couple of weeks' time, alright?
Yes, sir!
Now, Abomination, could you please go ahead and get some coaches ready for Brian to take out this evening?
Sure thing, sir!
Abomination excitedly steamed away as Brian grimaced down at his owner.
He makes me feel sick.
Yes, he does seem a little over-enthusiastic about going on display. Didn't take much convincing at all, did it? Oh, he'll love it, Zeke. He'll lap it up, being able to sit around idly and do nothing at all. Much like you, Dave and Raymond in years past, if I'm not mistaken. Hey, that was different. Not really. Besides, he'll grow tired of it eventually. At least, that's my plan. Brian looked curiously at Zeke. Plan? I didn't want to admit it in front of him, but Abomination has become incredibly lazy again as of recent, and I want to teach him a bit of a lesson. It's not so glamorous being stuck stationary in a museum for a lengthy period of time. Eddie would tell you that. So my idea is, if I leave him in the museum long enough, he'll practically beg us to restore him to working order again and actually do some meaningful work. Brian grinned broadly at these words. Zeke, you sly dog, you. But why do you have to punish me in the same way? For that, I am truly sorry, Brian. But it is true, I do require engines for display. But I promise you, once Mr. Smash reopens his works, I'll put you straight in for overhaul, okay? Alright, sir. But I want to request one thing, please. Sure, what is it? Please, please make sure that I'm placed as far away from that little shit as possible whilst I'm in the museum. Ha! Of course, of course. Cheers. Besides, you have a week or so before you have to be withdrawn, so make the most of it, alright? I will. Thank you. And with that, Brian slowly left the shed to collect his coaches, whilst Zeke slowly made his way back to the station, quietly quite amused by Brian and Abomination's polarising reactions. We'll be right back.